Good morning, children. Today we shall study a new chapter, that is whole and parts. Which chapter we are studying today? Today we shall study a topic whole and parts. First, we know its definition. Okay. So first we learn. What is whole? WHOLE. Whole. Whole means
one object. Or
here it's a one paper. Then it's consider it as a one whole paper. What we call it as is? It's called as a one whole paper.
One whole paper.
Whole paper. Then see, I have one paper. Then I fold like this. I have folded the paper. Like this, I have folded. See, I have folded equally. Right? I have folded it equally. Then I tear it. See? Then it becomes two parts. Okay? See, first I have a one whole paper. Whole means this one. One whole paper it is. Okay? Then I have divided it into two parts. See? Half of this one is one part and this one is one part. Okay, then part is nothing but here tear of the parts or cut it piece or a tearing of the two parts. Okay, see, this is called as the whole and the part. I give you other examples. If I have one orange, then I divide it into two parts. Two parts means equally. I have cut the orange into two pieces. Okay. See. One is the half part orange, then another one is this one is the other half part of the orange. See, it's a one whole orange fruit. Okay, then I have divided it into two equal pieces. Then we call it as a fraction. Okay, see how to write it? One divided by two or 1 upon 2. 1 represents the whole orange fruit and 2 represents the I have cutted the or I have cutted into its two parts. Okay, see, I have cutted the oranges into two parts. Then we call it as the 1 upon 2. So whole is nothing but whole one part of the orange and parts are nothing but I have divided or I have cut it into two equal parts. We call it as a fraction. So this we call it as a whole and a part. One represents the whole and two represents the parts of the orange. Understood, children? Next we go for the other example. I have a one watermelon. What is that? I have one watermelon fruit. Okay. Then I have cut it into three equal parts. See how to do this? One part, two and three equal parts. Then see one part, other one part and this one is the other part. See first part, second part and this one is the third part of the watermelon.
seeds, the one watermelon. I have cut it into 3 equal parts.
See, watermelon is nothing but one whole one watermelon is there. Then I have divided or I have cut it into 3 equal parts. Okay. Then we call it as the whole and the parts. Whole is nothing but one watermelon and the cutted parts represents the, these are the parts, or cutted pieces represents the 3 equal parts. Then how to write this? See, we can write it as 1 represents the whole watermelon. Then how many pieces I have cutted, children? I have cutted into 3 equal parts. So 3 is the parts and 1 is the whole watermelon. Okay. These are the examples for the whole and the parts. Understood, children? Next, we go for the other example. Sohan has a... Sohan is a one boy. He has one sandwich with He has one sandwich. Okay, like this. He has one sandwich that is made up of bread. Then he has given half to his friend Geeta. See, he has one, first he has one sandwich and then he has given half of this to, or he has cut it into 2 equal pieces. Then he has given half or other part to, one part he has taken and other part to has given to Geeta. Okay. See, how to write this in whole and parts? First he has a one sandwich. Right? He has one sandwich. And then he has given half to Geeta, or this part. One piece to Geeta. He has given that. Then how to write this in whole and parts? See, Geeta has a half sandwich and he has, Sohan has again half sandwich. Okay, then how to write this? See, 1/2. One represents the whole one sandwich and two represents the two pieces of the sandwich. Understood, children? See, one is called as a one whole sandwich. One whole sandwich. And two represents the two pieces of a sandwich. And this two represents, means it represents Sohan and Geeta has a half pieces, or both have equal parts of a sandwich with them. Okay, understood, children? These are the examples for the whole and the parts. Next we go for the other examples they have given in your textbook. The shapes that have been divided into halves or two equal parts. Halves. See, H-A-L-V-E-S. Halves means two equal parts. Two equal parts. The shapes that have been divided into halves or two equal parts. They have given some examples. Then you have to check it is half or 1/3. It means you have to take that it is divided into two equal parts or three equal parts. You have to check it. See, first one, we have given that one circle and they have divided into two equal parts. See, children, how to do this? You have
is the color C.
It is two equal parts.
How? First, it is one circle.
Then it is divided into two parts.
See, it is cut into two parts. Then each part is equal to the other one part.
You know the one circle, the circle in madidaru, erad part in madidaru, cut madidaru. Circle one circle, whole circle itu adna in madidaru equally erad cut madidaru pieces.
And then we get the two pieces. They are equal. ಅದನ್ನ ಏನಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಮಗೆ
ಅದು ಹೋಲ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಥವಾ ಹೋಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಥವಾ ಅದು ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಅದನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ತ್ರೀ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಟ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೋ ಅಥವಾ ತ್ರೀ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಸಿ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಟ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. See, so then we call it as 1 upon 2.
Right, children?
See, 1 is the whole one circle and 2 represents the 2 equal parts
or the cutted parts in the circle. So they have divided it into, they have cutted it into 3, 2 equal parts.
See, 1 upon 2. So this is the called as a halves. H-A-L-V-E-S.
Halves or
half. Okay, then we call it as a two equal parts. Two equal parts.
Understood, children? Like this, you have to do it.
Then we
go for the other examples. See.
Here one rectangle is there
and then
they have cut it into equal parts.
See how many parts are here?
First we have a one rectangle, right?
One rectangle.
Write it as one here.
Okay. Then how many parts are there here, children?
One and two. This one is one part and this one is the other part. They have cut it equally into two equal parts. Write it as a two here.
Okay, we call it as 1 upon 2. One represents the whole one rectangle. After that, they have cut it into two equal parts. Andre one in two rectangle into adin madidare equal piece again madidare cut madidare.
So we get it 1 upon 2. So one is the whole and 2 is the parts. These are the parts of a rectangle.
See, 1 and 2 are the parts of the rectangle. Understood, children? Next, we go for the
other example. See, they have given that 1 triangle. Okay, and this is called it as a
one triangle.
Then they have divided this into two equal parts. See, this is one part and this is the
other part. Okay,
see. This is an example. They have given one square. So it is like this. Both are same. Okay, then they have cut this into two equal parts.
Understood, students? First they have given a one square, then they have divided,
or they have divided into two equal parts. See, this one is the one part and this one is the other part. Here also same. This one is the one part and this is the another part. How to write this? One is the whole one square. And then write two here.
Because we have cutted the square into two equal parts. And then madidvi one square ittu, adu en madidvi one square ittu. Adralli en madidvi two equal parts agi cut madidvi.
So write one represents the one whole square and two represents the cutted parts. of the two equal parts of a square. Write it as 2. 1 represents 4 children, it is the whole. And 2 represents the part. One represents the whole and 2 represents the parts. Okay, these are the examples. So in your textbook they have given that you have to check it. Right, check it and put a right mark. If it is half or 2 equal parts, then you put a mark right like this. Otherwise, if it is not equal parts, then put a mark like this. Okay. Next we go for the other examples. See, in your equal numbers halves, equal number of the half, equal number of halves. See, equal number of halves. Okay. Equal number of halves means ಏನಿರ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲಿ equal number of halves ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ example ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. I will tell the example, then you will understand it. See, I have four mangoes. Okay. I have four mangoes. Then I give two mangoes to Sohan and two mangoes to Ram. See, I have a 1, 2, 3, 4. I have 4 mangoes, then I have given 2 mangoes to Sohan and 2 mangoes to Ramu. See what I did it here, children. First I have a 4 mangoes. ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಏನಿತ್ತು 4 ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ ಇತ್ತು. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, 2 ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋನ ಸೋಹನಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟೆ, ಇನ್ 2 ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ರಾಮುಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ 8 ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 4 mangoes. How many mangoes I have? 1, 2, 3 and 4. I have 4 mangoes with me. Then I have given 2 mangoes to Sohan and 2 mangoes to whom? Ramu.